Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. You know, there's been quite a roller coaster since Anthony Davis went out due to injury. We've seen a five-game winning streak for the Lakers. We've also seen losing streaks. And unfortunately, the Lakers haven't made up a ton of ground in the standings, currently still sitting on the outside looking in of even the play-in tournament in the Western Conference. And yet, when I look at this team and I consider the 19 games that they've been without AD, they are 10-9. That's if you're including the game that Anthony Davis left at halftime due to that injury occurrence. Well, you can't help but feel like that's about probably the best outcome we could have hoped for. Now, looking back, of course, there's plenty of instances where this Lakers team could have picked up wins and either a missed call or some botched plays down the stretch prevented them from doing so. But still, to be above 500 without Anthony Davis is fairly impressive. And let's face it, the games where they've lost, they really haven't lost by much. Give credit to Darvin Ham and to this team. They've fought each and every night and kept themselves in and given themselves a chance at least to win games. Here's what Darvin Ham said after the team's big win against the Grizzlies about the mental makeup and that grit, that toughness that this team has showed.
Ooh, it was a little bit of everybody. You know, Bron is going to always be Bron. You know, Pat Bev, he takes challenges. Dennis, I think Dennis, his defense early on with Ja in that first half set the tone, and he was locked in and really focused. Russ coming off the bench the way he did, you know, we gave up a ton of offensive rebounds with so many damn points, but it just guys just kept going. The energy stayed right, and we looked at it at half, watched our halftime edit, and just guys just knew, hey man, let's go win a game. You know, Juan Toscano Anderson, I said, come on, let's play together, let's compete, let's play together. He said, how about let's win? And guys just kind of, you just saw the whole room nodding their head like, yeah, it's about that time. And that spirit, it just carried us through the second half.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
Gosh, I love that story from halftime of the Grizzlies game where Darvin Ham is talking to his team about, hey, let's compete, let's stay competitive, let's continue to push and all of that. And then you get JTA, who, look, we knew this coming into the season, that he could be this kind of emotional leader, that he's got that quality to him, even though we don't see him on the court a ton. He gets some minutes here and there, very much a role player, but he's the guy who steps up and says, no, how about let's win this game? And how badly did the Lakers need that? We've seen them compete a number of times and fall short. JTA saying, how about let's win this one? And the Lakers did get out there and do just that. Again, Anthony Davis, hopefully back sometime this week, getting back into the mix. That would be another big boost for this Lakers team. Again, we would love to see them in the play-in mix right now, particularly with the trade deadline coming up now in less than 3 weeks and a lot of pressure on the Lakers to try to get something done. But I also think that what they've done in this stretch without Anthony Davis is they've given themselves a shot. They've kept themselves in it, in the hunt enough to where when AD comes back, hopefully if everyone else stays healthy again, fingers crossed, and if you can make a little bit of magic before the trade deadline, the Lakers can put themselves right into the thick of things in the Western Conference. Still a long ways to go to get there, but they haven't eliminated that possibility by keeping their heads above water here without Anthony Davis. But Lakers Nation, give me your thoughts on the heart, the hustle, the grit, the determination that this team has shown this season under Coach Darvin Ham. What does that mean to you as a Lakers fan, particularly coming off of last season, where we frankly didn't see much of that? Till next time, everybody. See ya and stay safe.